Hello, everybody. It is Monday, April 5th, and here are your national days. It is First Contact Day. Now, this is a Star Trek day. Star Trek First Contact Day is from the year 2063, and Zefram Cochran first took the first flight at a speed in excess of warp 1 in the Phoenix, alerting the Vulcan race that of their entrance, meaning humans' entrance, into the interstellar travel community, and then initiating the first contact. So this is one of those Star Trek days, and lots of people seem to have fun with this. Great series of movies if you've never seen them, and maybe today's the day you go and watch one, or even any of the different spin-off TV shows that all came from that very first initial TV show, Star Trek. All right, so see what's out there with the Star Trek front. It is Read a Roadmap Day. Now, this quickly becoming a lost art form. Growing up, we never had any of the computers or GPS things, whatever you want to call them, going through to give us the guidance and driving that we have today. So we would literally have to read a real paper map. And it definitely took some skill. Some people are way better at it than others. And maybe today's the day you just go take a look and do a little old school GPSing and see what you have there. All right, so Read a Roadmap Day. It's Flash Drive Day, and this is the day that we honor all those flash drives that we save our documents on, took things back and forth with prior to everything basically being stuck up in the cloud. And they were rather useful little tools, and still lots of people use them because, again, they're useful and functional. So why not use it if it's a very useful tool? So there you go. It is Nebraska Day, 37th state. It is the Cornhusker state, joining in 1867. It's Hospital Admitting Clerks Day. So these are the people that once you're there, they come in and take all of your information and get you set up so that you can make sure to get the care that you need. So if this is your job, or if this is somebody that you know in your family, this is a great person to celebrate today. Hospital Admitting Clerks. It is Go for Broke Day. Now, this is the day when you're going to face your fears, you're going to push past everything that has been standing in your way, and you're going to pursue whatever that goal is that you've had in front of you. So Go for Broke Day. It's Caramel Day, and this is one of those great words, and we always get into this struggle. Is it caramel or caramel? Whatever you're going to call it, today is that day. So the whole idea behind caramel is that you're going to cook some sugar down in with some butter, and then you add some vanilla, and then from there it kind of gets to that nice brown color, and you have your options on where you're going to go with it from there. What if you're going to add something to it? You want to make a turtle, something that they call a turtle. You've got the caramel with the pecans and some chocolate. You could just go with just the straight caramel itself. So there's lots of different options that you can have with this, but it's that sugar with the cream with the butter, cooking that all together, getting it to the right temperature, and then getting it to the right consistency for what you want to do. All right, so see what's out there. It is Deep Dish Pizza Day. Now, I grew up through the Pizza Hut time period when that was like a big deal. So that was the deep dish pizza. I've been to Chicago. I've tried the deep dish pizza from out there, and it's okay. I'll eat it, but it's definitely not my favorite. I'm more of that thin crust kind of guy, and I like having that little bit of a crunch of the crust. And when you get that deep dish, it's just there's so much stuff there, and a little too much dough for me. But it's pizza, and pizza is a great thing. So if I have to kind of suffer through a piece of deep dish today, okay, I'll suffer through a piece. But if you're a big fan, get out there and see what you can find, because there are lots of choices. You know, especially locally, you can go to Uno's and find something, but lots of choices out there. Deep dish pizza day. Those are all of our days. Let's take a look and see what our fact of the day is. So Neil Armstrong's hair was sold in 2004 for $3,000. All right, that's creepy. There's got to be more to this story. Let's see what's going on here. The lucky buyer, John Resnikoff, holds the Guinness World Record for the largest collection of hair from historical celebrities, reports NBC. Okay, there's a day for everything. Everybody collects different things. This dude, John, likes to collect people's hair. That's cool. The not-so-lucky barber, Max Sizemore, who cut Armstrong's hair, received threats of being sued by Armstrong's lawyers, who said he violated the Ohio law that protects the rights of famous people. Sizemore said he wouldn't pay, and Resnikoff said he wouldn't give back the hair, but that he donated $3,000 to charity. Okay. There you go. That's a fact. I'm not saying anything else. Go out there and see if you could find your deep dish pizza. Maybe go watch a Star Trek movie while you're having it. Finish it up with a little caramel, and you're good. All right. Have a great day, everybody. We'll see you back here tomorrow.